Hey, thanks so much for coming back to Jake's Face Reacts. I'm Jake. This is my face. You won't really see it react to this because it's a special video. These are my predictions, I should say, for the second semifinal of Eurovision 2018. I'm gonna start just like I did with semifinal one. I believe that there are two, six. Wow, just like last time. There are six countries in semifinal two that I feel like, again, as long as they show up and perform the way that they, have been performing, and there are no major catastrophes, that these six are pretty much a lot to make it through to the grand finals. I'm gonna show you the clips of those right now, and then I'll be back to just give you a little bit of insight into how I decided that these six were probably locks. But let's see who the six are. All right, so those were the six that I feel like they're pretty much locks to make it through, unless something should just go terribly wrong with their performance. And I don't rank these for the semifinals. I'm just telling you who I think is going to qualify. The order is completely random. So those six again were Sweden, Denmark, Australia, Ukraine, Poland, and Norway. These are going to be the ones that I think are gonna, take those last four spots. And again, I'm not trying to cheat, and I'm not, trying to cop out, but there are two countries that I'm not sure at all. So that's why for these last four spots, you're actually gonna see five countries. So these are my picks to qualify and take those last four spots from semifinal two. Let's go ahead and have a look at them, and then I'll be right back. I see that going through. Now, here's where I struggled, okay? Slovenia and Serbia. Serbia, if you go back and watch my reaction video, I really liked it. It was different. It seemed sort of ethnic to me. Now, as time has gone by, a lot of you out there from Serbia have reached out to me, either privately or through the comments to that reaction video, and you've said things like, this doesn't represent Serbia. They're not singing in our language. We don't support this song. And if you're saying that about your own country's entry, it just kind of makes me wonder, who else from that semifinal is going to vote for you, and I'm not sure. So that's why, I'm not sure between Serbia and Slovenia. Now, I love Slovenia's song. Hvala, wait, Hvala, I can't do it, I'm sorry. Hvala ne. Lea Sirk, she's again been at pretty much all of the promo events, but I'm getting the vibe from you guys again through your comments and through your messages that you don't think that the jury or the televoters are going to show any love to Slovenia, and you've given examples of songs, from other years that were similar to this one and did not qualify for the grand final. So although, I like the song a lot, I mean, it's crazy. I'm just not sure that it's gonna get what it needs to qualify for the actual final out of semifinal two. Okay, so what you're about to see now, and what I'm probably gonna get a lot of hate from, hey, and just remember, because a lot of you were so mad about my picks, my predictions for semifinal one. Don't take this personally. This is my second year to even watch Eurovision. I don't know anything. I've tried to do my research and I'm trying to be honest with you, and you know that I am because I would never have put Norway automatically through if I hadn't done my research enough to know that even though I didn't like the song at all, I still don't, that he's gonna qualify. Having said that, a little nervous, but here are the songs for me that I don't see qualifying out of semifinal two. Semifinal two. Okay, take a deep breath. Russia. There's so many things that I could say about this. And to me, you know, it's the most watched reaction video that I've made to Julia's live performance of this, at Moscow Vegas, which I now know is a mall. Thank you very much, all of my friends out there for telling me that. But if you saw that reaction video, I mean, I you can go back and watch it, and I was shocked, honestly, that she was put out on the stage in that condition in the first place, and then you heard what happened in the choruses. I mean, it was shocking. It really was. It was shocking. I know that people keep saying it's Russia, so they're gonna qualify. They're automatically a lock. It's Russia. It's Russia. It's Russia. I don't care if it's Russia. I really don't. This is a song contest, and part of that has to rely on the vocals, and they're not there. Which is sad because, if you're gonna write a song for someone to sing, you need to make sure that they're able to sing it. And again, I'm just being honest. I don't think that people, should put her through just because she's from Russia. I don't think that people should put her through just because, they may feel sorry for her. It's not a reason to put someone through. Look, she's inspirational. She is. She's waited, 2 years, and she's gonna get her chance to perform. And I know you guys are going crazy, and you're talking about they're gonna bring in lifts, and they're gonna bring in a mountain, and they're gonna do, all this other stuff. And Russia is very smart, and I'm sure that they saw that Moscow performance, and I'm pretty sure the backing vocalists now are just gonna sing the chorus for her, and she's gonna do sort of the other part, which is, again, sad. But it shouldn't make it through because of special effects or, a mountain or lifts. Listen to how it's performed, okay? Please. And if your heart still tells you after you've watched Semifinal 2, and who knows, it could be completely different. If your heart still tells you that that's one of the best performances, hey, vote for it. You have the right to. And I can't take that away from you. But what I am saying is that I don't think that it's fair for Russia to take a spot in the semifinal from another country, that deserves it more because they can sing their songs live. And they, I hope you know that this is not coming from like a place of me trying to be mean. I'm just being honest. I just hope that you vote with your hearts, and I hope that you vote for the best songs and the best performances on that night. And if it's anything like it was in my other reaction video, it wouldn't be fair for it to go through. It just wouldn't. And I love you, Russia. And a lot of you have sent me messages and comments, and you've, said, look, we don't support this. We didn't get to pick this. We didn't even have a final. We were just told that this was our performer, and that was that. And that's very sad to me because you guys have sent quality acts in the past, and I hope that next year you get the chance again to choose your act, because how unfair is it that you can't even really be proud of or support, your own artist? I don't know. It's sad to me. Who have I? Well, I'm sure that I've left someone off, but as you know, I always pick a dark horse, right, from each of these. One that I think, could surprise people, may have been written off, but I'm telling you to not write them off because in the first semifinal that my dark horse pick was Albania, Eugene Bush Peppa and his song Ma. Here's my dark horse pick. I didn't forget this one. Here's my dark horse pick for semifinal two. Just to give you. All right, so yeah, that's my dark horse pick for semifinal two, Montenegro, with Ilario, Ilario? No, Inye is what it's called. He has been at a lot of the pre-parties, and I just have to say that he has a really awesome personality, and he's kind of not taking this whole thing too seriously, which I love, and he's having a good time. But don't be fooled, he can sing. And this is a Balkan ballad that is so beautifully written and sort of builds and builds and builds until that ending, until that crescendo where it's awesome and it's amazing. It's my dark horse pick because a lot of people are just saying no, that it's not going to qualify to write it off. I'm saying don't write Montenegro off because the song is strong enough and he has the personality and the voice, I think, to possibly be able to nab one of those spots, take one of them from someone else. All right, yeah, so those are my predictions for semifinal two. Again, I don't need hate, so if you're gonna leave comments, that are hateful, whether they're towards me or towards the countries or towards, other people that are commenting on it, don't do that. Like, there's enough channels out there that, tear people down and, rely on being mean and on, being hateful to stand out, and that's not me, and it shouldn't be you. If that's you, I don't know if you should be, watching my videos, 'cause that's not me. I just want to go over one more time just so we're all clear. Here's who I think will qualify for semifinal two. Again, these countries I think are pretty much for sure going to qualify. Denmark, Sweden, Ukraine, Australia, Poland, and Norway. Those six I th think are locks. The next four was where I kind of struggled, but the Netherlands, Moldova, Hungary, and then it could be either Slovenia or Serbia. It could be my dark horse pick, which was Montenegro, that could nab that last spot. It could even be Latvia or Malta that gra I mean, it could be a lot of these acts. But that's sort of the conclusion that I came to. If you've hung in there with me this long, I really appreciate it. I love every single one of you, and I appreciate all the views. I try not to keep track of that because it scares me a little bit. But I've been overwhelmed by the amount of support that I've been given from you guys, and I cannot wait for Thursday night. No. Yeah, Thursday night for semifinal two. To see what's gonna happen. Like, I'm so excited. And I could be wrong about everything, and that's fine. That's why it's a prediction. It is what it is. All right, I love you guys. Peace.